Over our short human history here in New Zealand, we've been losing various beds of scallops around the country. Normally, to assess the status of a scallop population, sampling's done either using the same dredges that they use in the fishery. Or we're conducting diver surveys. Diving has very low impact, but it is quite intensive. What we're trying to do is develop a non-invasive method of surveying scallops that actually collects imagery flying above the seabed and be able to get the same level of data that we could do from our traditional dive or dredge surveys. A non-invasive camera-based method of surveying scallops is having no impact. And machine learning is going to be a key advance in that.
The goal is to compare our robots' counts with the divers' counts and sizes.
We've tested the divers and we know that they're almost 100% effective at picking up the scallops, so we know that they're good. By running the two teams together, we can compare what one's seeing to the other and see if there's anything that's missing.
We're sending a video stream live from the ROV to the surface, and that's what we can view on the screen. You can never have enough data for training artificial intelligence.
We can manually view the images and identify the scallops that are in there, but obviously that's quite time consuming. And so to make the whole process more efficient, we can use machine learning to actually detect the scallops for us.
The artificial intelligence is what's called a convolutional neural network, which basically slides a bunch of stencils over the camera image, and it's a scallop-shaped stencil, and when it goes over a scallop, you know, it fits, the pattern fits, and that's a match for a scallop.
You know, it costs so much to have a dive team there, and even then the areas we can cover are quite small, whereas an ROV could be chucked in and work for hours and hours and hours. So the cost efficiency of being able to survey and monitor these beds becomes a lot more viable.
Habitat and population surveys could be as simple as throwing the ROV overboard, building up an image, and then you can analyse that image and have that geo-referenced as well.
And the next step beyond that is also to see if we can accurately size the scallops. So using cameras could really open up the opportunity to get much better coverage and really improve our understanding of not only the scallops on the seabed, but the habitats and other marine environments.